please, if there's anything that you could ever do for me that I would ask of you, okay, anything, screw money, that's not going to help. What I want you to do is please go and spam every single targeted individual, every single TI on YouTube, go to every single gangstalking channel, or anyone ever that talks about gangstalking in any way, go spam their channel by telling them to either watch this video or teach them yourself how to do the death psalms. Okay? Because this stuff works. My gangstalkers, they don't exist anymore. They're all dead. How did they die? From these words that are about to come out of my mouth. They're freaking dead, man. There's CIA guys that are dead. There's FBI people that are dead. Cops dead. EMS guys, a bunch of medicals are dead, man. Unemployed wetbacks, niggas, and honkies, all dead. Dreamers, dead.
The Lord.
I pray people to death and they fucking die. Okay, they die. As the obituary column just filled with gangstalkers.
Dead.
This stuff works.
I'm in trouble.
If it wasn't Christianity, people would call it witchcraft, but that's basically what it is. You're casting spells. Like Christianity, we call it prayers, but it's really no different than witchcraft. These death psalms and all the psalms in the Bible. The Bible is basically a big book of witchcraft spells. It's really what it is. The difference between witchcraft and Christianity is only one thing. The source of the power. With witchcraft, the source of power is with the devil and other demons and fallen angels that disguise themselves as good creatures, which they are not. With Christianity, the source of power comes from the all-being
entity.
Yahweh, which is the creator,
the universe is the universe.
You don't need to understand the numbers and numerology and gematria and that crap. They do, because they don't obey Yahweh. They don't obey the Creator. You don't need to do any of that. Neither do I. He knows everything because he created everything. He knows all the gematria. He's on the moon and the barrel codes. He knows all that. You have to be obedient, family. You have to obey him. Obey his commandments. The Ten Commandments, start with that. And once you get those, then start following his dietary laws and the other stuff. Okay? But Jesus Christ overcame the law. But you still have to obey his commandments. You still have to obey the commandments, okay? It's just that you're living under the grace, and if you break the commandments, you're not going to go to hell. Whereas before Jesus Christ came in the flesh, you broke the commandments, you did suffer the potential of maybe going to hell and hellfire. Like David, he did have Christ, and he killed Uriah the Hittite so that he could take the Uriah the Hittite's wife into his concubine, right? Moses killed the man, right? So they all committed grievous sins. Did they go to hell? Of course not.
But
there's no price to save them. Why? Because the grace of the Most High Power is more powerful than his laws. He wants you to obey his laws, but he wants you to believe in his grace, man. Okay? And so when people are picking on you, or people are trying to